Hi everyone. I promised there'd be a second video about the recent trip to a clinic in Talisay, so here goes. Now let's see, I recently paid for some plastic surgery, but whereabouts? Not down there, not there, not there. Ah! There it is, the nose! Brand new nose, yeah. Yeah, looking pretty good. My friend said that she looks like Cleopatra now, haha. Or what's the other character? Penny Pitstop?
Yeah. I don't know that.
No. But what about your friends and family?
They said that it looks like really, really transform into pointed nose.
Yeah, well, totally. It's less wide. And
than
a bit more pointed and narrow compared to before. Yeah. And how do you feel about it?
I feel about like more confident when I go in a mall, meet my friends.
Cool.
Thank you, Daddy, for this rhinoplasty.
No worries, babe. You're worth it. And in case you hadn't noticed, we're in a new apartment now as well. So had to buy a new sofa and everything because this was an unfurnished apartment. First one I've tried. It's in a duplex, but across that wall there's no one in there. I think the landlord is keeping it as his holiday home, so it's actually really quiet. That's convenient. And they were offering that one fully furnished in Filipino style, which means you have to buy lots of extra furniture and stuff, for $19,000 a month, whereas this unfurnished was just $15,000 a month. So do the maths, right? You save 4,000 pesos a month, that's 48,000 pesos in a year, and you can actually buy a lot of furniture and appliances for 48,000 pesos. So, you know, I reckon, and if I'm mumbling, that's because, you know, I've got a serious distraction here. So I'd say it's really worth it. An unfurnished apartment means, one, you can buy all the furniture you actually like rather than put up with something somebody else bought real cheap ages ago, right? And it pays for itself in just a year or two, particularly since we moved in December and there were 25, 30% discounts on all the furnishings and appliances at every store for Christmas. Wicked. So my mum's first ever quilt she made is our sofa cover, you know, a cheap dining table set and stuff like that. The little bit less kitchen space than we're used to though, but the storage is still good. Bathroom and whatnot. Got a tub of water because there is a water curfew here. This is in Cantilly, Upper Cantilly, sort of halfway between Dumaguete and Valencia. And I don't know why, but there's no water delivery between midnight and 3 o'clock in the morning. So we've got the big tub because, you know, you come back from a party or something and you want to shower at 1 a.m. or whenever. So the spare bedroom, it's 2-bedroom for the same price or less than we were paying before. And the master bedroom through in here, all pretty nice. The garden, oh, it's not much. It's because it's very recently built. This apartment is still not on Google Maps yet, right? So weeds and stuff are coming up, but that little cottage is nice. Yeah. At least there's morengo trees and there's papaya trees coming up, banana trees and stuff like that. Pretty cool. But I'm going to have to organize this space with a lot more plants and nice palms and stuff like that. It'll look really good. Yeah. This neighborhood, it's a real Filipino neighborhood, right? So there are dogs and roosters and stuff around. We've got really nice Filipino neighbors. There are some other foreigners living in this area though. I haven't really met many of them except for my direct neighbors here, which are nice. And it's also a little bit warmer because we're about 100 meters lower in altitude, but it's no problems really, especially because the apartment is brand new. It's got very high ceilings, insulation, flow through ventilation. We don't only use the aircon at night in the bedroom, you know? Yeah, so We don't hear the chickens and dogs and stuff at night, probably because it's the room's closed up with the aircon going, so it's not a problem at all. But it is nice to have real Filipino neighbors around that are friendly. We all say hello and stuff, so pretty cool. It's less socially artificial than, say, living in Dulce Vida. Oh. Did I mention that another advantage to being in Upper Cantilly instead of Valencia is there's way less brownouts here. In the last month, we've only had one short one, whereas up there you'd probably get a few, including all-day brownouts. Mm-hmm. Mm. How's that nose? Wow, look at that.
Wild thing, I think I love you. But I wanna know for sure.
You making me a coffee, babe?
Yep.
Thanks. You know, you're perfect. So that's it for now. Thanks so much to all my new subscribers. That's great. Yeah. And I'm thinking about planning a big trip pretty soon when the weather improves. Go with a couple of other guys on bikes for a long ride through Mindanao to check some of that stuff out and get a few videos about that. Show you some pretty wild places. I hear there's big 6-meter long crocodiles down there.